Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, how are you guys? I hope all of you are in a good health. And I will always remember to take care of your health. And follow health protocol when you are outdoor. Okay, on this occasion, we will study together even though we still cannot learn directly. But we can learn together to this learning video. Please listen to this short story. Lida did the best scores in her class. Her mother and father take Lida to a historic place as for her. Their first destination was to visit Borobudur. Their second destination was to visit Monas. And their first destination was to visit Tangkuban Perahu. After a vacation, Lida tell and describe what she saw. This time, Lida will describe about historical destination. Do you know what is the descriptive text? Descriptive text is a text that describes a particular person, animal, place, or thing. Descriptive text adalah text yang menjelaskan orang, hewan, tempat, atau benda tertentu. You read a description when you want to reader to picture what you are describing. Teman-teman, kita menuliskan descriptive text ketika kita ingin menjelaskan apa yang kita lihat. Purpose of descriptive text. Purpose of descriptive text to describe person, thing, or place in specific. Generic structure of descriptive text. Generic structure of descriptive text. The first, identification. Identification, this part to introduce where or who this subject being described is. Bagian ini menjelaskan tentang di mana atau siapa yang dideskripsikan. And the last, description. Description is the part, so the detailed description of subject, it may include the information about appearance or quality of. Bagian ini menjelaskan atau menunjukkan deskripsi detail subjek termasuk informasi tentang penampilan atau kualitasnya. Language feature of descriptive text. Language feature of descriptive text. The first, using simple present tense. The second, using adjective and a verb. And the last, using present passive voice. The first, using simple present tense. Dalam simple present, kita menggunakan verb one. Untuk subject I, you, they, we, kita menggunakan verb one. Sedangkan subject she, he, it, kita menggunakan verb one plus s or es. For example, Borobudur is one of historical building in Indonesia. Not only become a new tourism destination to a lot of travelers around the road. Borobudur Temple consists of 6 square floors. It is a place your hand to the stupa to one of the hall. You can to the Buddha statue. The second language feature using adjective and a verb. whether temporal, using adjective, historical and well-known, using a verb. Example, in Indonesia, in Magelang, in Enugskolis, on its level, on the top center. The last language feature of descriptive text, using present passive voice. Present active. Subject plus verb 1 plus object plus a verb. Present passive. Object plus is, are, plus verb 3 verb by plus subject plus adverb. Agar teman-teman semua semakin paham, mari kita perhatikan teks berikut. Setelah itu, kita kerjakan soal-soalnya bersama yuk. First question. How many facilities can be enjoyed by visitor? A. 2. B. 5. C. 22. D. 36. Okay. Pada nomor 1, kita dapat melihat pada paragraf kedua ada kalimat visitor can enjoy more than 36 kind of facilities. Jadi, ini menunjukkan jawaban kita ya. The second question, what does chatting part offer? A. A place at Kartika number 2 as Java. B. A place for reaction and a steady center. C. 22 hectare land use for Kiai Hasan House. D. A sports center for family and students. Jadi, pada soal kedua ini, kita dapat menemukan jawabannya pada paragraf pertama, di mana pada kalimat ini, Jatim Park offers the region place as well as a study center. Jadi, ini menunjukkan jawabannya ya. Jadi, jawaban kita adalah B. A place for reaction and study center. The third question, what the main idea of the second paragraph? A. Galeri Nusantara located next to the gate. B. Each Java temple is this place miniature size. C. There are a lot of facilities in Jatim Park. D. Their Sumberawa statue is tourism object in Jatim Park. Untuk menjawab pertanyaan ini, kita dapat melihat main idenya pada paragraf kedua, di mana diawali dengan kalimat visitor can enjoy more than 36 kind of facilities. Ini berarti there are a lot of facilities in Jatim Park. Jadi jawaban kita adalah C. The last question. The reaction area offered previous tour. The underland world is possessed in meaning to A. Important, B. Viable, C. Cheap, D. Good. Untuk menjawab pertanyaan ini, kita harus mengartikan bagian-bagian pada pilihan tersebut. Di mana pada kalimat ini, verbal memiliki arti yang sama dengan previous. Jadi, jawaban kita adalah B. Oke, jadi teman-teman, soal yang sering muncul dalam descriptive text adalah menanyakan tujuan, kesimpulan, persamaan kata, ide pokok, dan kata rujukan. Tertarikkah teman-teman mengunjungi tempat bersejarah dan wisata lainnya seperti yang dilakukan Lida, serta mendeskripsikannya kepada teman-teman yang lain? Sampai di sini penjelasan kita tentang descriptive text. Sampai bertemu lagi di pembahasan lainnya. Wassalamualaikum.